There's a way of being that goes with it. And that's one group. It didn't used to be like that. I mean, people were essentially, there was a homogeneity in culture that enabled us to be together as humans. So if you went to Rawalpindi, or if you went to Kabul or Herat or these places, there was a pretty much unified culture. It had class. There was class, because socioeconomic class determines things. But every class was pretty much harmonized, and there were similarities. They dressed the same. They had the same frames of reference. And so there was a homogeneity that enabled them to feel a esprit de corps, a type of what Ibn Khaldun called asabiya, the thing that holds things together. And that's one of the reasons why we're so fragmented now as people. We're becoming more and more fragmented, and people are withdrawing into their own autistic type of experience of life. So you have the iPod culture, which is very interesting. I mean, people walking around in a completely different reality than you're in, literally, because they're hearing songs or whatever they're hearing. I mean, people listen to different things. They might be, I saw a guy, he was walking, and he was saying, hablo, hablas, he was learning Spanish, you know, on his iPod. So some people do useful things, but a lot of people, they're just bopping along, right? And the iPod commercial to me is really amazing, because it's a shadow with these iPod earplugs. It's like the person's not even there anymore. It's just a shadow of a person. You know, whoever thought of that ad was just, I think, really brilliant, because they got to the essence of what that signifies. What you're doing is you're allowing somebody to put everything into you. Your thoughts are being dictated by somebody else, because what you're thinking about is what's being plugged into you, whether it's the song or whatever it is. And then there's no silence. People are losing the ability just to be silent, just to sit in silence. This is the human condition in the West particularly, but this is now being, it's a hegemonic culture. Somebody said to me, do the Muslims really want to take over the world? I said, no, they're reacting to our taking over the world. Right? I mean, that's what's going on. It's like this monolithic Western culture, everywhere it's going, it's changing cultures radically, and people are reacting to it. It's so disruptive. And then we kind of look at it like, you know, we're not taking over the world. McDonald's, just because we're in Mecca now, just because everybody's eating McDonald's, wearing jeans, listening to the same type of music, we're not taking over the world. It is. It's a cultural jihad. That's what it is. It's a cultural crusade, because it's overwhelming all these cultures everywhere. Traditional crafts, people can't compete. The shoes they used to make by hand, you can make it in a day, a million of them in some factory in Japan or somewhere. How do you compete with that? I mean, the Saudis used to have these, they called them Nijdiya sandals. They don't wear them anymore. Only the real Bedouin type people wear them, because now they wear Birkenstock versions of them that are a lot more comfortable. They are. I have a pair. I used to wear the Nejdia, and then when Birkenstock came out with the same style, and it's all fit to your, you know, and then your foot will, after a while, it's ergonomically designed to be perfect for your nafs. It used to be just feet were feet. You put it in the shoe, but now it fits your foot. It's amazing. And how do people survive that without becoming just monsters, infant monsters? Because we get what we want. And then we get impatient when we don't get what we want. I mean, that's the current human condition. That's why everybody's out there in this state of stress and anxiety, and they're so used to getting what they want now. You know, the computer's not fast enough. People come to Saudi Arabia and I'm used to a DSL line. I'm sitting there waiting and the thing's going like that. In California, you push the button and it's instantaneous. But when we first started using the computer, they were slower than they are here. And it wasn't a problem then because we didn't have that expectation. So once you get the expectation of speed, it's hard to deal with the slowness. And that's what happens to the nafs. The more and more, and Sayyidina Umar said, "Ikhshawshinu fa inna ni'mata la tadum." Be tough on yourselves because blessings don't last. "Ikhshawshinu fa inna ni'mata la tadum." It's an amazing statement by Sayyidina Umar. In other words, if you're always accustoming yourself to being in comfort, and when you find yourself outside of that comfort zone, suddenly you can't take it. And it becomes very difficult. So basically, the human condition is in crises. I mean, there's no doubt. It's always been in crises to some degree, because just being human is a crisis. Just the fact that we're here and living in the world, there's an aspect of it that has that crisis component. And people that work in ERs know that better than most people. There's always something about to happen, or something happening, or something just happened, always. I mean, that's the nature of life on Earth.